Hello, hi there, everybody. Welcome to today's live lesson. Lovely to have you with us. I can see people already saying hello in the chat. Hi, my name's Joe, and I'm in France. What about you? Where are you joining us from today? Let us know when you say hi. Hi to you, Mohammed, in Somalia. Nice to have you with us. Hi, Ahmed, in Egypt. Can we see some more countries? Myanmar. Hello, Julia. Welcome back. I think I remember seeing you before. We've got people in Ukraine. Hi there. Hong Kong, Burma, Morocco, Pakistan. Hi, Yuli. Georgia, Tenerife. Wow. Okay. As always, lots and lots of different countries, and great to see so many of you with us already. Perhaps while people are joining, we started a little bit late today, I'm afraid. So perhaps we should have a look at a bit more detail about today's session while people are still joining us. So today, we are going to be talking about Sherlock Holmes. And mysteries. So we'll first of all have an introduction about Sherlock Holmes, and we'll look at some vocabulary to use when we're talking about mysteries. Then we'll have the grammar, which today is narrative tenses and past question forms. And then it will be your turn to solve a mystery. So we've got a mystery story which we're going to show you today, and you are going to help be detectives to solve the mystery. Okay. Hi. My name's Joe Mohan. Nice to meet you. Okay. Lots of more people have just joined us. Great to have you all with us. Welcome. Welcome to everyone. Okay, so today we're talking about Sherlock Holmes. So it's a special day. I think it's the anniversary of the birthday of the writer of Sherlock Holmes. What do you know? What do you know about Sherlock Holmes? Can you tell me in the chat what you know about this famous detective, Sherlock Holmes? In the meantime, I've got people coming into the chat, people joining us from North Africa, Turkey, Brazil. Hi to everybody that's just joined us. And can you answer that question that just popped up on the screen? What do you know about Sherlock Holmes? Okay, have you heard of Sherlock Holmes? Or perhaps this is the first time you've heard of Sherlock Holmes today. Okay, good. Hina says a British detective. Right, good. Do you know if Sherlock Holmes was a real life detective or a fictional detective? Is he just in stories? I know he's a great detective. Yes, exactly. He was really famous for being so good at solving mysteries. Yes, he was clever. Sherlock Holmes had wit. Yes, good. He was also, yeah, had that very special kind of humor. Arthur Conan Doyle. Yes, exactly. That's whose birthday it is, his an the anniversary of the writer of Sherlock Holmes. Ahmed said he's a police officer. Okay, so he's a special detective who helps the police with very difficult cases. He was an expert and he solved mysteries. Good. He was a smart man. Excellent. Yes, he had a friend, Dr. Watson. So his friend often helped him to solve the mysteries. Good. Okay, Maria, that's a fictional character. Absolutely. So, a fictional character is somebody in a story. He wasn't real. He was just made up from the imagination of his writer. He was well known for his great observational skills. Absolutely. Cookie, is wit related to humor? Yes. Wit, that's a kind of a special kind of humor, a clever kind of humor. the main character of Arthur Conan Doyle's novel. Yes, he's very eccentric, absolutely, but a clever detective. Good. You know a lot about Sherlock Holmes already. That's great. I've seen lots of other comments there that we haven't had time to read all of them. Some of you have got quite a lot of detail there on Sherlock Holmes. If you want to find out more about him, there's so much you can see on the internet. And I think we've got some links on our Facebook pages there where you can find out more about him. Okay, so we're talking today about murder mysteries. That was what Sherlock Holmes was good at solving, murder mysteries. And we've got some crime words here. We've got some letters missing from these words. Can you, in the chat, can you write the complete words that go, what does eccentric mean? Oh, that's a good question. Eccentric means that you do things which are quite out of the ordinary, quite extraordinary. You're maybe quite surprising in a way. Okay, that's eccentric. Kind of not what people think of as like normal behavior. Okay, good. The first one, Yassine has got that one. Detective, excellent. Clue, yeah, super, Kavita. That's the right answer. Victim, yes, good. Somebody here has just said he lives on Baker Street. Yeah, Sherlock Holmes, that was his very famous address, 221B Baker Street, a famous address in London. Okay, back to the words. Witness, yes, good. That's the person who saw the crime happening. Alibi. Yes, excellent, Maria. So the alibi, this is like proof that a person can't have committed a crime because they were in a different place or with somebody else when it happened. Okay, that's a good crime word, an alibi. A suspect. Yes, that's one of the people who we think could have committed the crime. Have we got more? Information, that's a good guess there. Yes, information. Motive, yes, the motive, that's the reason that somebody has for the crime or the murder. Okay, lots of answers here. Detective, victim, suspect, alibi, clue, witness, evidence. Yes, very good. Can see some lots more and some words we didn't even have there too. Okay, let's have a look at the answers. I think we got most of these. Detective, victim, suspect, alibi, clue, witness, evidence, motive, inspection. Yeah, there were a few possibilities there, beginning with I and ending I-O-N. But here we've got the inspection. Okay, so that's our murder mystery vocabulary. And I've said that we're talking today about Sherlock Holmes. So we've got a little story for you today. And this is the introduction to the story. Now, I'm just going to tell you now, this story wasn't written by Arthur Conan Doyle. It's not an actual Sherlock Holmes story. We've just written it for you, just to have a little bit of fun with the grammar. So let's see. Can you listen to the beginning of the story? And can you tell me what are the tenses of the verbs in bold? Okay, we're concentrating on tenses today. It was a dark and stormy night. The phone rang at 221 Baker Street. So remember, that's Sherlock Holmes's address. Scotland Yard needed Sherlock Holmes to investigate a murder at the mansion of the wealthy businessman, Mr. Gregory. So that's the beginning of the story. Irina, yes, simple past, good. Lots of people are saying the past tense. Yes, it's the past tense and specifically past simple tense. Excellent. So was, rang, needed. They are the past simple tenses. Yes, Maria, that's right. Okay, Diana also. Lots of people are getting this right. Brilliant. Okay, so we've got some of the stories in the past simple. Now we've got something different. Can you tell me what tense this is? Mr. Gregory's assistant had found his body in his study. He had been shot in the chest. Okay, had found. Mr. Gregory's assistant had found his body in his study. What tense is that? Can anybody tell me? Some people are saying past tense. It's still a past tense. Diana says, yes, specifically, it's the past perfect. Yes, also past perfect. Bright says past perfect. Yes, past perfect. Okay, lots of people have got this. Excellent. So, had found his body. That's the past perfect. Good. So many of you in the chat there have got that right. Okay. And now the next part of the introduction. The wind was howling and the rain was pouring down heavily when Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson arrived at the scene of the crime. Okay, so the wind was howling and the rain was pouring down heavily. What tenses are those? Can you tell me? Can you tell me in the chat? Was howling and was pouring. Okay, good. Hina said past continuous. Good. Yes. Philip, past continuous. Arena agrees it's the past continuous tense. Kavita, Min, past progressive. Yes, good. Past continuous. Excellent. Okay. Very good. Past progressive. We can call it that, or we could call it the past continuous. Yes, good. Okay, somebody's asking why. We're going to look at that in just a few moments. So, why have we got all these different past tenses to tell a story in the past? Well, it kind of makes it a little bit more exciting than this version. What about this version? Same story, but here we've just got the past simple. Somebody shot Mr. Gregory. Scotland Yard phoned Sherlock Holmes and asked him to come and investigate. Holmes and Watson arrived at the mansion. So, there, what tense are all of those verbs? I'm sure you know because you knew it in the other version. So, here, when we can see all of these verbs are just in the past simple, okay, so we've got that happened, then that happened, then that happened. All in the past simple tense doesn't really give us much suspense or much excitement, or it doesn't tell us what was happening in the background when these events happened. So we use all of these different kinds of past tenses to tell a story, and not just the simple past. I can see you've got that right there in the chat. For this more boring version is the simple past. So the past tenses that we were looking at, we can also call these narrative tenses. So a narrative is like a story. And somebody, Laurette here, has just said to tell the sequence of the events. And that's a really good point, Laurette. And that's what we're going to look at in our grammar explanation of why these narrative tenses can help us to tell the sequence of events. And maybe the verb that we see first is not the first action that happened. So here we've got, we call this a timeline when we see the past and then goes through to now. And where we've got start, this is the start of our story that we've just had. The phone rang. Do you remember the phone rang at 221B Baker Street? Okay. Scotland Yard asked Sherlock Holmes to investigate, and Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson arrived. So those are our verbs which we had in past simple. We identified those, didn't we, as past simple? And there we can see them on the timeline in the order that they happened. The phone rang, Scotland Yard asked, and Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson arrived. So, boom, 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 three events in the order, three past events in the order that they happened. Okay, but now let's add one. Past continuous. So the wind was howling, the rain was pouring. You can see that little pink wiggly line underneath the verb arrived. So the wind was howling and the rain was pouring down when Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson arrived. So this weather, this bad weather, was already in progress when they arrived. So we use past continuous to talk about an action that was in progress when something else happened. Okay, so that's used to give us some background to the action. Okay, and okay, Mr. Ahmed says, what's the difference between these tenses? Okay, so the difference is the past simple we're using to describe finished actions in the past. The past continuous we're using to talk about something in progress when that past simple action happened. And now we're going to look in more detail at the past perfect. Okay, so we said the start of our story was the phone rang, but we're going to go back in the past to find out what happened before that. So before the phone rang, he had been shot and his assistant had found his body in the study. So that must have happened before, because when the phone rang, it was the police asking Sherlock Holmes to come and investigate. So we've got the past perfect there to tell us about something which is further back in the past, and this action was already complete before something else happened. So he had already been shot before the police called Sherlock Holmes. And I think we've got one thing to add. Yes, so in the past perfect, we can also use the continuous form. So, for example, he had been working all evening. So again, it's past perfect. It's going back to something which happened further back in the past before the phone rang. But we're focusing now with the continuous form. We focus on the activity and not on the result. So the past perfect continuous form focuses on the activity. Okay, so I think we've seen here now how and why we use the different narrative tenses. So what we're going to move on to now is how we use these in questions, because I'm going to get you to ask some questions shortly. Okay, so when we make questions in the past simple, you probably know this already, we usually use the auxiliary did. So, example, did you hear anything unusual on the night of the murder? So that's a yes, no question. Yes, I did. No, I didn't. With a question word, what did they see in the garden? Okay, so those are with the auxiliary did, but with subject questions, we don't use did. So who was in the house at the time? This who replaces the subject. For example, the butler was in the house at the time. Okay, so that's the past simple. What about past perfect? So we use had plus the person plus the past participle. Had they argued before the night of the murder? So there we could put any past participle that we wanted. Had he, had they, plus past participle. And in the continuous form, had plus person plus been plus verb plus ing. What had they been saying? Okay. So they had been arguing about their business, for example. And now the past continuous. We use was or were plus the verb plus ing. Was it raining when they arrived? or with a question word, what were you doing at 8 o'clock yesterday evening? So there we've had lots of examples of questions which could be useful for you for the next part of the lesson, because we're going to come back to the murder mystery story that we saw the introduction to, and we're going to have a look at it in a little bit more detail. And I'm going to give you some suspects, and I'm going to ask you to ask me questions and to find out information that will help us solve the mystery. So perhaps you have just joined us, or perhaps you can't remember the story completely. So let's go back to the story. I'm going to read it for you again. So the story. It was a dark and stormy night. The phone rang at 221B Baker Street. Scotland Yard, that's the police, Scotland Yard needed Sherlock Holmes to investigate a murder at the mansion of the wealthy businessman, Mr. Gregory. Mr. Gregory's assistant had found his body in his study. He had been shot in the chest. The wind was howling and the rain was pouring down heavily when Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson arrived at the scene of the crime. Okay, so there's our introduction to the story. We're in the house of a very rich man, and he has been murdered. He has been shot. And we need to find out who shot him. Who is the murderer? Okay, so first of all, let's see who are our suspects for this this crime, this murder. We've got three suspects. We've got his business partner, Mr. Green, his nephew, Peter, and his personal assistant, Miss Jameson. So I want you now to pretend that you are one of the detectives and you're going to investigate this murder. Can you ask some questions using the grammar that we've just looked at? So use the past simple in questions, or the past perfect, or the past continuous, and find out where were these people at the time of the murder and what were they doing? Did they get on well with Mr. Gregory? Had they had any arguments? And what actually happened in Mr. Gregory's office? Okay, so let's see. Manuel, when Sherlock arrived at the scene of the crime, he took over control of the investigation. Yes, good. Okay, so remember right at the beginning we had this word alibi. So the alibi is the proof that somebody is not the murderer because they were in a different place or they were with somebody else at the time. So we want to know, does Mr. Green, does Peter, or does Miss Jameson have an alibi? So you can use some of these, we put the beginnings of the questions there to give you some ideas. And we've also given you some clues. Okay, we've already got a question. Where have you been at the time of the murder? Okay, perhaps there we could put this into the past simple. Where were you? Where were you at the time of the murder? Okay, so where was Peter? Okay, so let's ask specifically about Peter. So I'm going to give you an answer. At the time of the murder, Peter was in the house and he was visiting his uncle and he was upstairs in the bedroom. Okay, so Peter was upstairs in the bedroom. Have we got any more questions? You can use those clues there to help you, ask some questions. Okay, had you any debt of Mr. Gregory? Ah, okay, Diana, I see what you mean. Were you in debt to Mr. Gregory? So you mean, did you owe Mr. Gregory money? Good idea. Very good idea. But no, nobody owed Mr. Gregory any money. Have we got another question? Did anyone see Peter? Yes, they did. The butler saw Peter in his bedroom just before the murder took place. Who found the body? Okay, Irina, subject question there, so we don't need the auxiliary did. Who found the body? Miss Jameson found the body, his assistant. She was the person who found the body. Where was Mr. Green? Good question. So Mr. Green was at home at the time of the murder. Perhaps you can ask me if he was with somebody else so that we know if he has a really good alibi or not. Okay, I can see some other good questions here. What was Peter doing there in his room? In his bedroom, Peter was asleep in his bedroom. I've got a question here I'd like to answer. Was the window broken? I think that's a good question. And the answer is yes, the window was broken. Where was Miss Jameson when everything happened? Says Dilson. Okay, good. So Miss Jameson, she was in her office, which was just outside Mr. Gregory's study, and she was working late at the time. She was doing lots of work. Did anyone call him? Do you mean did anyone call Mr. Gregory? Not sure which of the people there you're talking about, but nobody called Mr. Gregory. Did anyone have business disagreements? Attic. Yes, they did. Mr. Green had had quite a lot of arguments with Mr. Gregory in the months before this happened. I think the Mr. Green wanted to take over the business. He wanted to take control. What other questions have we got? Did anyone check what was in his pockets? Aha, very good question there, Diana. Yes, well, Sherlock Holmes checked what was in Mr. Gregory's pockets and he found a love letter. So, a love letter was in Mr. Gregory's pocket. Let's get on to the motive now. So, we're getting there already, I think, with the motive. So, I think we found out already, just in terms of the alibi, Mr. Green was at home in his house, Peter was in the bedroom, and Miss Jameson was in the office. Did Mr. Green and Mr. Gregory have a business disagreement? Yes, they did. They had quite a few business disagreements and arguments. Maria has got a good question. Did Miss Jameson have an affair with Mr. Gregory? Well, to be honest, Maria, I don't know if they had an affair, but I'm sure that Miss Jameson was in love with Mr. Gregory. And she had been in love with him for a long time. That's who wrote the love letter? Okay, good question there, Mohammed. The love letter was signed by Lily. So Lily is the name of the person who wrote the love letter. Did anyone see Miss Jameson or talk to her? Well, the butler saw Miss Jameson when he came to give Mr. Gregory a drink before bedtime. Mr. Gregory always had a cup of cocoa, you know, a cup of hot chocolate before he went to bed. And the butler, before he went to sleep, he came to give Mr. Gregory his hot cocoa, and he did see Miss Jameson, who she said she was working late, but he didn't see her doing much work, but she was sitting in her office at her desk. Were there any disputes between Miss Jameson or anyone? Well, actually, no, Charlene. Miss Jameson hadn't had any disputes or any arguments with anyone. She always got on very well with Mr. Gregory, and actually, she was a very good personal assistant to him, and she made actually a lot of good decisions for him, a lot of good financial decisions. She had made a lot of money for him in his business, but they hadn't argued. Where were the money bag and other personal belongings? Okay, good question. So there was money and probably other valuable things were in the safe. So the safe, which was in Mr. Gregory's study. Okay, we've talked. Did Peter have any debts? Yes, he did. Peter was very bad with money, and his uncle was very rich. But Peter was the kind of person who just spent and spent and spent lots of money. So he did have a lot of debts. Who wins money with Mr. Gregory's death? Yeah, so who gets money if he dies? Well, I suppose perhaps Peter was in his will as his nephew. Mr. Green, well, maybe he gets to take control of the whole business if Mr. Gregory dies. And Miss Jameson, his personal assistant, perhaps Mr. Gregory has left some money to her in his will, since she helped him so much with his business. Maybe that she would inherit some money too. Good question, Vanessa. Did any of them hear when the window was broken? Well, Mr. Green didn't, because he was at his house. Peter was fast asleep in the bedroom. He didn't hear anything. And Miss Jameson, well, I think she was the one that rang the police. So she says that she heard the window break, and then she came in, discovered the murder, and phoned the police. Was there a possibility that Peter and Miss Jameson were lovers? Ah, well, this is a good question. And I think in a lot of stories, there are often two people working together, aren't they? When they're two lovers working together. But no, not in this case, Manuel. Peter and Miss Jameson were not lovers. Who wrote the letter that Miss Jameson had got? Well, the letter was actually in Mr. Gregory's pocket when he died. And Lily, I told you that the person, the name of this person was Lily. But we don't know Miss Jameson's first name, do we? Perhaps could somebody ask a question to find out if the letter was from Miss Jameson? So many good questions. I wonder if we should move on now to try and really find out what happened. Let's just try to get to the bottom of this mystery now and find out what actually happened. Can you ask some more questions? Can you use the clues in the box? Somebody's asking about the letter. Maybe somebody could ask me something about Miss Jameson's name, which is one of the clues that we've got there in the box. That might help us a little bit. We found out there was a love letter. We found out about broken glass. Did the pieces of broken glass, maybe we could put fall, in or out of the room? This is a good question, Malik. When Sherlock Holmes discovered the broken window, the broken glass was outside in the garden. Somebody's asked the question I was looking for. What is Miss Jameson's first name? Miss Jameson's first name is Sarah. Okay, so do you remember? The letter came from Lily. Miss Jameson's name is Sarah. Okay, so somebody, that was a good question about the glass. That the if the glass was broken and it was outside in the garden, where was the person when they broke the glass? Aha, yes, it means the window was broken from inside the house. Yes, that's what it means. What was there in the pocket? Okay, so in Mr. Gregory's pocket, there were two letters actually. One was the love letter. It was a love letter from a woman called Lily. And I think I can give you some more details about that love letter. In the love letter, it said that Mr. Gregory and Lily were going to get married. And there was another letter too. And I think the letter had been written earlier that day by Mr. Gregory himself. And the letter was a letter for Miss Jameson. And it said that he was going to sack her. So he was going to write a letter to say that he didn't want Miss Jameson to work for him anymore. So that's a little bit more of a clue for you there. Two letters. So who do you think the murderer was and why? Do you think it was Mr. Green, the business partner, who maybe he wanted to take control of the business? Perhaps he would make a lot of money from taking control of the business. Was it the nephew, Peter, who was upstairs? He said he was asleep upstairs in the bedroom, but we know that he needed money. He had lots of debts, and perhaps he would inherit money in the will of his uncle. Or was it Miss Jameson, who we know that she had worked for Mr. Gregory for a long time? She really liked him. But we also know there had been a love letter from somebody else. Maria's just said. So if the letter came from Lily and the first name of Miss Jameson is Sarah, she can't be the same person, right? Yes, you've got the right idea there, Maria. So it seems as if Mr. Gregory was in love with somebody called Lily. Okay, Lorette, we're getting closer. Miss Jameson, because of deception. Okay, so I think the murderer is Miss Jameson because she loves Peter. Okay. Somebody else saying the murderer is was Miss Jameson. Okay, somebody else thinks it's Peter. Pfizer says, I think Miss Jameson, she was jealous. Okay. Whittier says, Peter, he needed a lot of money to pay his debts. Okay. Min, I think Mr. Green was the murderer because he loved Miss Jameson. Okay, good idea. Yes. Maria, in my opinion, the murderer was Miss Jameson. She killed him because she was jealous of him. Okay, yes. So, lots of people have got, I think, are almost on the right track. And I think probably this is the minute when Sherlock Holmes will reveal everything to us. So here is the case solved. So, when he was taking Mr. Gregory his evening cocoa, The butler had seen Peter using the telephone in his room on the other side of the house. So Peter had an alibi. He had also seen Miss Jameson in her office next to Mr. Gregory's. Holmes discovered a love letter in Mr. Gregory's jacket pocket from a woman called Lily. The letter said that Lily and Mr. Gregory were planning to get married. There was also a letter to Miss Jameson sacking her. Miss Jameson had seen the letters on his desk earlier that day. She had waited for the butler to go to bed, had gone into the office and shot him. After shooting him, she broke the window and stole the money from the safe to make it look like a robbery. And then she called the police. And with the case solved, Holmes and Watson left the mansion satisfied with their deduction. So there we go. Somebody's just saying, what a pity, they've just come. Watch it on, you can watch the recording later. I hope you don't remember there who the end of the story, and you can watch it all again from the beginning. Okay, so that was the story. So Miss Jameson was the murderer, and a lot of you were right. She was jealous when she found out that he had been having a love affair with another woman. She loved him. She wanted to marry him. And she got so jealous. Then she killed him in a moment of passion. And I think some of you, were you right? Let me know if you got the right answer. Maria says that, yes, I was right. That's really satisfying, isn't it, when you read a detective story or watch a film and all the time you're thinking about what could it be, and you get the right answer. So what about you? We're really short of time now. It's nearly time to finish. But if you'd like to, tell me, do you like mystery stories? Did you like our story? Did you like trying to solve it? And have you got a favourite detective story? Let us know. So some people say you got it right. Some people got it wrong. Okay, whether you got it right or wrong, I hope that you were able to see some of the narrative tenses in the story, and that it was useful for practicing the grammar as well, for asking the past simple or the past perfect questions. Lorette says, I liked it. Good. Excellent. Yes, you liked it too. Oh, good. Your favourite. You like detective stories. Excellent. Okay, you've just arrived. What a pity. It was an interesting topic. Watch it on the recording and then let us know in the comments if you enjoyed it. Yes, I liked it all. Me too. I had fun with the detective story. I hope that you'll join us again for our next live lesson. Thanks for all your questions, all your comments. The Hound of the Baskervilles is my favourite. Yes, I think that's probably the most famous Sherlock Holmes story. Could you suggest me some books and detective stories? Maybe we can do that. We can go back onto our Facebook page and put some suggestions in there later on, or if anybody else has got some suggestions. It was very useful. I liked it very much. I'm glad to read that, Philip. It was so funny, says Maria. Excellent. Good. Okay. I love detective stories, especially Agatha Christie. Yes, another great series of detective novels. Oh, Min, thank you. I love the way you instruct us. That's really nice to read. Thank you for that comment. Okay, I think we have to finish now. So thanks for coming. Thanks for joining in, and hope to see you again next time. Bye-bye.